Jenny in Tome, New Mexico. You're up next. Hi, Jenny.
Hi, how are you?
Great, thank you.
I had a couple Jehovah Witnesses come to my house the other day, and their angle was kind of funny. They started talking about the Bible, and I was like, no, I don't want to talk about your Bible. And then they kind of went for the health thing, which I thought was kind of funny.
The what thing?
Jenny, the what thing?
The health, like, if you pray or you meditate, we'll work on your, it'll help decrease your stress levels and your diet. They start talking about diet.
Health thing.
Sorry.
Become a JW and you'll be healthier.
Right. We're selling you a good medical bill of goods. Okay. Interesting.
And then, so I was like, well, you know, I'm in the health profession and I pretty much know what to do to take care of myself. And I said, well, you know, before you leave, why don't we sit down and just say a prayer together? And they're like, oh, no. We will keep our good thoughts for you, and you keep your good thoughts for us. And they left real abruptly. Why don't they want to pray? I mean, who wouldn't?
That's a good question.
Here's the reason, Jenny, that they won't pray with you is because you pray to a different God than they do, basically. That if you pray as a Christian to God, and you believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, from their perspective, if they were to join in a prayer with you, that would be on par with you joining in a prayer with a Muslim, for example, to Allah, that they would say, well, no. We don't pray the same way because they have a very distinct theology. They can't pray to Jesus as their God any more than you could pray to Michael the Archangel, which, ironically enough, Jehovah's Witnesses believe are the same person, essentially, that Jesus and Michael the Archangel are the same. Now that Jesus has ascended, that's who he is, and that's how he'll return. So I think that's the way to bring them out. And you can ask them, well, look, aren't you Christians? And if we're both Christians, shouldn't we be able to pray together? Like, Patrick, I would say even for the most vociferous Protestant critics of the church, I have no problem sitting down with them and praying over a meal or praying at an abortion facility.
Mm-hmm.
I know that this Protestant and I, even if they really think the Catholic Church is bad, we both pray to the same God. That theology we are in line with, we disagree about, you know, ecclesiology and sacraments and things like that. But with the Witnesses, to ask them, well, are you a Christian? That will start to show the differences aren't just about ecclesial matters, about the gospel, even though those are differences still. But the differences lie at the very core of what it means to be a Christian. And that's essentially, Jenny, why they won't pray with you, because they want you to apostatize, to leave the Christian faith, to leave the Catholic faith,
yep,
and join their church instead.
I knew a guy in Los Angeles who we were friendly. He was a workout trainer, very nice guy.
Mm-hmm.
And we got talking about faith issues, and I gave him a copy of Joel S. Peters' essay, which appears in This Rock magazine, called How to Prove Christ's Divinity from the JW Bible. And this guy had not been to Kingdom Hall, mm-hmm, in 20 years. He was actually shunned because he had a daughter out of wedlock. And I said, here, check this out. And he wouldn't let it touch him. He let, mm-hmm, it fall to the ground.
Right.
Now, he's been out for a long time. He's actually shunned. But that mindset of don't read apostate literature,
that is something that could get you shunned. Shunning is a practice with Jehovah's Witnesses that those who break moral laws or reject the Jehovah's Witness faith are not allowed to, that communication with them is cut off even from other family members. And actually, so the Witnesses are told, and I've documented this in my booklet, that material that goes against their faith, that criticizes their faith, should be avoided as if it were some kind of an actual disease or pornographic material. They say, just as you wouldn't read a pornographic magazine, would you read something that attacks your faith?
So doubt or something that threatens the organization is believed to come directly from Satan.
Right. And so anything that's critical of the Jehovah's Witness faith, the Witnesses are told not to read. But this creates a double standard, because the Witnesses bring their materials, like Awake magazine or Watchtower magazine, to your doorstep. They'll give you free magazines, and many of those articles criticize what Christians believe. It says that Christians, Protestants, and Catholics believe in unbiblical things, that they've corrupted the doctrine, their churches are corrupt. So they want us to read things that critique our faith, but they won't grant us the same courtesy.